France has taken one of the most active roles in intervening in the uprisings that have been raging in Africa and the Arab world. Apart from Libya, it also sent troops to its former colony, Ivory Coast. As RT's Daniel Bushell reports, all signs show that the eyes of the French government are now turning to Syria.
Salem's cousin was shot by troops during Syria's protests. His parents there now live in hiding. But he fears France will make things even worse by bombing his country on the pretext of stopping the violence.
I don't wish to have jets and I don't know, and air force in Syria, but I expect it in 2 weeks.
He notes the same chain of events that brought war with Libya are now unfolding at home. First, Syrian leader Bashar al-Assad was invited for talks in Paris, as was Colonel Gaddafi. But at the same time, France reportedly was funding opposition groups in both states. Now Nicolas Sarkozy's government is slapping Damascus with sanctions, the precursor to the invasion of Libya. Humanitarian aid, says one author, will again be their excuse to go in.
The logic of their intervention in Libya is that they should intervene in Syria also.
Syria was once under French occupation, but analysts say France behaves as if it's still in control.
France, they've had their spies there for decades now, and religious movements have had their people there for decades, so that they're going to do whatever they can to use their influence to change the regime in a way that they see fit.
Intervention would leave France fighting in four wars. That hasn't happened since it was a colonial power.
The French Defense Ministry hasn't been this busy in over 50 years. Already fighting in Afghanistan, Libya and the Ivory Coast, it's now turning its sights on another former colony, Syria.
But experts think the real target is Syria's key ally, Iran. France is growing increasingly angry at Tehran's nuclear ambitions and is part of international moves to stop that program. Damascus would become a springboard for the Sarkozy administration as it pushes east.
If events in Syria progress according to the Libyan scenario, we will probably see a similar development in Iran, unfortunately. That is, Iran will repeat the Syrian scenario.
Russia watches Western military interventions with rising alarm. It warns they're fueling violence across the Middle East.
Deliberately escalating a conflict is an invitation to a series of civil wars. Outside forces should not interfere, give advice, or take sides in internal conflicts.
But Russia's foreign minister adds there could be a sting in the tail. He says unleashing chaos in the region helps the very extremists the West wants to stop gaining power. Daniel Bushell, RT, Paris.